Back in the early 60s, there was a small blues band that was on the rise called the Hellebores. The band was named after the founder and lead singer's favorite flower, which came in many colors, but the black Hellebores were his favorite. As he is quoted as saying, he found beauty in their darkness. The lead singer's name was Dion Velarde, along with guitarist Evan Montana, drummer Avery Jackson, and bassist David Lassen. They made up the Hellebores. In the summer of 1964, they were set to record their first single on cassette tape, hoping to submit it to radio stations and begin their journey to fame and fortune. Dion was more obsessed with this idea than any of the other members. Friends and family have said he spent most of his time practicing his singing meticulously. However, the band would not receive any fame. Band would disappear sometime during that summer, seemingly without a trace. The families of the band members think the record label tried to cover up whatever happened due to a possible lawsuit, but there is evidence that slipped through the cracks that might give an idea of what happened. The most popular rumor is that Dion Velarde, who had an interest in and possibly practiced black magic, tried to achieve fame and fortune through supernatural. Some believe Dion made a deal with the devil. For Dion's soul, the devil would make the Hellebores' first single a listening experience like no other. Some members of the studio have pointed out that Dion had brought a cassette tape of his own to record the song on. Dion kept it clutched in his hands. He only let the tape go to put it into the recorder. I think it had some sort of strange writing on it, says an anonymous studio member. The cassette tape itself adds to the mystery, as it also went missing along with the band. It is believed the devil gave Dion a special cassette tape, one that, by being a vessel for the song, would give it supernatural ability. The strangest thing is, even though the band was never seen again, the tape has been seen many times. The tape has been documented as being sighted in various locations across Canada and the United States, seemingly at random. Barns, attics, bridges, and more. Most never know the curse they take home with them. Those who have taken it all mysteriously go missing. Police records for missing persons from all over have had a tape written down as evidence, all matching the same description. Every time the tape gets taken into evidence as a possible clue for where the missing people might have gone, it always goes missing before investigators get a chance to listen to it. Then appearing again in a new location, days, months, or even years later, as the cycle repeats.